The tidal wave Kensei set was revealed to us nearing a month ago. The katana is called the Safe of the Deep. It's a four-shot katana with a funky shot pattern which may seem a bit impractical, because it is. Even with the inverted shot pattern, it's impossible to hit all four shots unless you're standing in point-blank range. The damage is pretty good. It's a little bit lower than Enforcer, however its true range barely even exceeds two tiles. My guess is that it will drop from the Royal Nidarian. Log Sheath is a pretty damn good sheath and it's got pretty good trail damage, matches that of a tier 5. It shoots out four shots of 200 damage and summons a typhoon lasting for 8 seconds that follows you around whenever you dash. You can have a total of 3 nados out at once and they deal 50 to 100 damage per shot and shoot just about over 30 times. The stat multiplier of the sheath is dexterity. For the sake of this video, I ran 75 nests to see the maximum amount of dex you can get with this whole set equipped without using horn, effusions, tinctures, any of that. And let's just say, it's quite a lot. And to be fair, it does make sense, judging that 3 of the 4 pieces grant dexterity upon equip. My assumption is that this will drop somewhere in the ocean trench, hopefully not from Thessal herself. I'm pretty sure she has enough ST sets going for her right now. The barrier reef is like, eh, whatever. It's just like your standard ST armor with a passive. But to be fair, I kinda like this one. Heals for 200 HP whenever you shoot below 50% health, with a 25 second cooldown, of course. However, this passive is only available when paired with the Alexander's Ring. It grants the same defense as a Vengeance armor, with an added 4 dex on top. Not the best, but the passive makes up for it. I'm unsure where this will drop from, probably from one of the minions in the ocean trench. Alexander's Ring is the final part of the set, and I don't really have much to say about it. This ring alone is absolutely worthless, you know, like most other ST rings, but its primary function is to propel the usage of the barrier reef. From the item's description, I think it's pretty obvious that these are going to drop from Dying Thessal's Coral Gifts. The full set bonus grants 120 health, 60 MP, 20 dexterity, and 10 def. We could definitely compare the set to the Horticultural Huntress set in a way that they both grant an absurd amount of dexterity when the full set is equipped. The full set bonus skin is also wonderful. I've dyed it pink to match my pet, and I think it's up there as one of my favorite ST skins with Crystal Kunoichi and the Scarecrow Trickster. For this series, I have 3 ratings: aesthetic, usability, and personal enjoyment. These are just my opinions, so please don't take these as gospel. Aesthetic, 10 out of 10. It reminds me a lot of Tanjiro's water stances from Demon Slayer, and I'm a big, big Demon Slayer fan. Usability, 6 out of 10. The katana's true range really lets this set down, however rightfully so because this damage shot is slightly worrying. And for personal enjoyment, 8 out of 10. I really enjoy playing with this set, however if I could change anything, I'd remove the 4 projectiles from the lock sheath and put more power into the typhoons, so there isn't that much going on. That'll be it for this video though, thank you so much for watching. If there's another item or ST set that you want me to review, please put it in the comments below. Yeah, until next time.